What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRiderYT.com and I'm back once again with another Oracle database tutorial. And today in this tutorial, we will learn about SQL file parameter of IMPDP data pump import. Most probably, this will be the last tutorial in Oracle data pump import and export series. So let's jump ahead and see what SQL file parameter is and what is its use. As the name suggests, SQL file parameter generates a SQL file or say SQL script based on the other parameter in IMPDP data pump import. This script contains all the DDL that would have been executed by IMPDP data pump in background to perform the import. There are few things which you must know about SQL file parameter. First, the SQL script created by this parameter only contains the SQL DDL statement and no other type of statements. Second, whenever you use SQL file parameter in your IMPDP data pump import command, then IMPDP utility does not actually perform an import. Rather, it just generates a SQL script and your target system remain unchanged. So let's move on and do some examples. In the first example, we will see the use of SQL file parameter with table space import. This is a simple import command which on execution will import the user's table space into target system because I haven't yet added the SQL file parameter to it. If we will add the SQL file parameter to this command, then this command will only generate the SQL script rather than actually performing the table space import. So let's add the SQL file parameter to this command and then execute. Now on executing this command, IMPDP import will generate a SQL script which will contain all the SQL DDL statements which are executed by IMPDP data pump import in background for importing the table space into the target system. Let's execute the command. Import is successful. And here is our IMPDP command which we just executed. So let's check out this SQL script which we just created. The location of the script will be the directory that is pointed by the directory object exp_tblsp which we used as a value of directory parameter. Hence in this case the location of the script pointed by the directory object is d data pump table space export. And here we are and here is our SQL file. Let me open it for you. And as you can see, these are all the SQL DDL statements executed by the IMPDP data pump import. So if you are a keen learner and want to see how data pump import works, then you can take help of this SQL file parameter. Okay, let's move ahead. As IMPDP data pump import does not actually perform an import when SQL file parameter is used, therefore in some cases, you can use this feature to your advantage. For example, suppose you have a dump file and no other information such as what kind of data this dump file contains or say what type of export made this dump file. Then to find out all these information, you can use SQL file parameter of IMPDP data pump import. But remember to find out what kind of export made the dump file requires high level understanding of DDL statements as well as experience. Let me demonstrate it to you. But first, let me clear the screen so that we can see things properly. Okay, here we go. Here in this IMPDP command, I used orcl_full.dmp dump file, which is in the directory d data pump full export pointed by directory object orcl_full. On executing this command, IMPDP data pump import will create a SQL file named check.sql in the directory pointed by orcl full directory object. Let's execute. Import is successful. Let's check the SQL file. And here it is. Though I already know that the dump file orcl_full.dmp is created by full database export, but still if you go through this SQL file, you will find that this SQL script contains DDL for creating table spaces, profiles, users, tables, roles and many more, which clearly indicates that the dump file used is created while exporting full database. That's it for today. I hope you learned something and enjoyed the tutorial. If you like this video, then please hit the like button. You can also share the video on your social and help me in reaching out to more people. Do comment or tweet your feedback. More important, don't forget to hit that big red button and subscribe to my channel. I will see you soon with another tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.